We're in the middle of a comedy. Andy has just walked in his house. He's got nothing on but his underwear and a tiger shirt that's got half sleeves. Ugh, that's not even... Are they rolled? No, they're not rolled up. They would have... Well, they could have been rolled up so they could put barbed wire on his wrists. I don't even remember. No, I think they're half sleeves. It's like you want him to look stupid. Anyway, he just re-entered the cabin. Maybe something's going to happen. Nope, you stand there. The lighting's fluctuating again because... Well, now I think it... No, the TV's not on. This is just stupid lighting. And he's looking around like an idiot. And he's looking at the floor. And so he looks down at the ground behind the couch. And two things. One, putting the couch with the back to the door is weird. I don't like it. Two, I want to guess. I'm thinking he sees her shoes. You know, that means something to him. Never mind her stuff that's on the couch. The blanket they probably share that's on the couch and a couple feet in front of him. All of her drawings off to the left. I hope that shirt is hers, but it's not. Let's see what he actually sees. Pressing play. Oh, he's leaning down, taking his time. Lighting's doing stupid things. It's a... Oh, it's 44 shirt. Of course it is. Wait. Okay, so apparently the fluctuating lighting in this room was supposed to be the TV was on. That doesn't make any sense. They went to bed, which means the TV should be off. Plus this stupid TV fluctuating lighting was going on outside, which doesn't make any sense. TV's inside. And the TV wasn't on when everyone else was sitting around the couch. And they were sitting around the couch in the cabin because it had all the... Well, it wasn't this couch. It was... How many rooms do they have with couches? I don't care. Actually, the cabin's kind of nice. It'd be cool. But worse, looks like the TV is right next to the fireplace, which is a horrible place to put a TV. But it's possible the TV is on a table that moves, because the edge of it looks flimsy, so maybe it's on wheels. But it doesn't matter. They're still watching Channel 13, and we're getting... When I first finally managed to watch this movie all the way through, I posted on Facebook that the cheddar goblins might be the only good part of the movie. At this point, I'm kind of annoyed by them. First of all, before I even press play on the cheddar goblins, they have a better production quality, I think, possibly than the film so far. They certainly have better lighting. That is a head-to-toe costume we got in sight already. It looks like, or it might be a puppet. I don't know. I can't tell the size. I'm going to press play. I think it's a puppet. And then kid says something. And then we cut to Andy staring at it. Big open mouth. I understand his mouth was wounded, but couldn't you have done something else to him so he didn't have a stupid open mouth stare everywhere? Like, we don't need to see him in stupid doofus shock. Reminds me too much of Busey. And Fishmouth, for that matter. I'm trying to hear the Cheddar Goblin commercial, but I don't think I can. I went backward. So the little girl in the commercial says, "Cheddar Goblin." She waves her finger at him. "Did you eat all the macaroni and cheese?" Cheddar Goblin says, "There's nothing better than cheddar." This is all off screen. We're staring. Instead, we're looking at frickin' Andy with his doofus mouth. I had forgotten what cheddar goblins do. The cheddar goblin proceeds to vomit macaroni and cheese into the big bowl in front of the little girl. Okay, that is funny. It has no place in this film. Yeah, it has no place in this film. Oh, vomits on top of her head, too. And now there's some black kid with her. He wasn't there before. Vomiting on him as well. That's good. An announcer's voice comes in. Cheddar Goblin has 60% more cheese than the next leading brand. And then back to Andy staring at it as... Kids, something about kids agree, and the commercial's still going, but I don't care. I'm not gonna try to do a special Cheddar Goblin episode. Screw that. He doesn't deserve it.
I don't have time for this today.
That's not even my desk.